In this video, you'll learn how to track clicks in GA4 using Google Tag Manager. You can use this technique whenever you want to report on particular elements people are clicking that aren't automatically tracked in GA4. For example, you might want to track when people click a particular button, when they click a particular item in your menu, or when they click on a banner you're featuring on your homepage. Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. I'm going to walk you through some examples of different clicks you might want to track into Google Analytics. We're going to track these custom clicks using Google Tag Manager. And after we've walked through click tracking, I'll also cover clicks that Google Analytics can automatically track. Okay, let's jump in and get started. We're looking at my demo site and we can see there is a banner at the top, along with a button. So let's walk through how we can track people clicking on this button. To do this, let's head to Google Tag Manager. There are different ways you can identify the element you want to track, so you can configure your tag, trigger, and variables in Google Tag Manager. In this video, I'm going to show you the approach I use, which is really useful because it will show us what's automatically available for us to use without having to spend time guessing the best approach. To do this, let's navigate to Variables. We can see there are some built-in variables that are already enabled for us. If you're new to Google Tag Manager, variables let you capture different information from your website to use in your tags and triggers. For example, we can see there are built-in variables for page hostname, page path, and page URL. We can use these variables to understand the page someone is looking at on our website. The hostname gives us the domain name of our website. The path is everything after the domain name, and the URL is the domain, the path, and any query parameters and fragments. There are additional built-in variables. To view these, let's select Configure on the top right corner. We can see the built-in variables that have already been enabled. Let's scroll down. And let's enable the built-in variables under Clicks. These are click element, click classes, click ID, click target, click URL, and click text. These are super useful because they will give us information about the elements we click within the website. While we're here, I also want you to go ahead and enable the built-in variables under forms, as we'll be using these a little bit later. So let's also enable form element, form classes, form ID, form target, form URL, and form text. Okay, now let's close this. And let's navigate to triggers. Now let's click new. Let's name the trigger, click all elements. And let's select Trigger Configuration. Now let's choose All Elements. This trigger will fire every time we click on the website. We're not going to use this to fire any tags, but what we are going to do is use it to identify the elements and the information for the elements that we do want to track. Okay, let's save the trigger. Now let's click Preview. Enter the URL for our website and click Connect. We can see our website loads and Tag Assistant is now connected. This means we can click the element or elements we want to track as we travel through our website. Since I want to track the button in the banner, let's click this. Now let's open the Tag Assistant tab. We can see there are two click events on the left. There's click and link click. We can use either of these to identify how to track the button. Since link click is more precise than just click, let's select this option. Now let's select the variables tab in the middle. We can now see all of the built-in variables we enabled, along with the values Google Tag Manager has identified. We can see click classes, click element, click ID, and so on. Scrolling back up, we can see the class for the element as sqs-button-element-primary. Let's copy this. And scrolling down, we can see the click text is learn more. This is the text for the button element. We might want to use this too, so make a note of it just in case. Now let's head back to the website and navigate back to the page with the banner. It's worth checking to see if there are any other links to the same page or any other elements that might be tracked too. Basically, we want to ensure that we'll only be tracking clicks on the element that we want, and that we're not tracking any other clicks by mistake. The only other link that goes to the same page is in the menu. If we wanted to be extra careful, we can click this, and then open the Tag Assistant tab again. We can then select the new link click event on the left. And checking in the Variables tab, we can see that the click class variable is actually blank, so it's not the same as the class for the button we clicked earlier. This means we can now configure a trigger and tag to track the button in the banner. So let's head to Google Tag Manager. And let's create a new trigger. Let's name the trigger Homepage Banner Button. And let's select Trigger Configuration. And let's choose Just Links, because we identified that we want to use the link click event. Now let's select Some Link Clicks. Ensure that Click Classes is selected. And let's change Contains to Equals. And let's paste the class we copied from Tag Assistant. Now we could probably just save the trigger, but to be extra safe and ensure we're only triggering our tag for the button we identified on the home page, let's click the plus sign to add another condition. And let's change click classes to click text. And select equals. And enter learn more as the value. And let's add one more condition. Let's select page path. Then equals. And enter forward slash. This means our trigger will only fire when these three conditions are met. So someone needs to click the button with the correct class, the button needs to contain the text Learn More, and it needs to be on the home page of our website. Now let's save the trigger. And let's navigate to Tags. Let's create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Analytics GA4 Banner Click. Now let's select Tag Configuration and choose GA4 Event as the tag type. Now let's select our existing GA4 configuration tag. And I'm going to enter select_content as the name of the event. This is one of Google's recommended events, but you can name your event anything you like. To learn more about events and how to name them, I've included links to extra resources in the description below this video. Okay, now let's select Event Parameters and click Add Row. Let's enter content_type as the name. And let's enter banner as the value. Let's click Add Row again. Let's enter location_ID as the name. And now let's select the click URL variable as the value. Using the variable means that we will automatically be passing the URL of the element that's clicked. You could add additional parameters for your tag, but I'm going to leave these two, and let's scroll down and select Triggering. Now let's select the trigger we just created. This is the Homepage Banner Button trigger. And let's save the tag. Now let's click Preview. Tag Assistant loads. and we head to our website. Now let's click the button. And let's open the Tag Assistant tab. We can see our banner click tag has fired, and we can select the GA4 measurement ID at the top. This shows us the events that have been sent to Google Analytics, and we can see our Select Content event. Let's select this. And near the bottom, we can see the two parameters we created along with their values. Okay, let's head back to the website. We're going to configure a trigger and tag to track when people click the Sign Up button on this page. So let's complete the form. And click Sign Up. Now let's head back to Tag Assistant. And let's select the last click event, which is for the button click. And looking at the Variables tab, we can again see the variables and information we can use to trigger a tag. Let's scroll down. We can see the form class's variable. Let's copy the value. And let's scroll down. And we're going to copy the form text value. And the page path value. Now let's head to Google Tag Manager and navigate to Triggers. Let's create a new trigger. Let's name the trigger Email Sign Up Form. Let's select Trigger Configuration and let's choose Form Submission as the type. Since we only want to track when people successfully complete the form, let's enable the Check Validation option. I need to flag that this option doesn't always work. It will depend on your form, so as we'll see in a moment, we might need to adjust how we trigger our tags depending on our form. Since we've enabled the Check Validation option, we should limit our trigger so that it only fires on particular pages. So let's select Page Path. And enter the path we copied from Tag Assistant. Now let's select Some Forms and select Form Classes, then Equals, and paste the class we copied. Now let's add another condition and select Form Text, then Equals, and enter the text from our button. Now let's save the trigger. Let's navigate to Tags. And let's create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Analytics GA4 Newsletter Button. And let's select GA4 event as the tag type. Now let's select our GA4 configuration tag. And let's enter generate_lead as the name of the event. I'm going to skip adding custom parameters, so let's select triggering. And let's select the trigger we just created. Now let's save the tag. And let's click preview. Our website loads. And let's complete the form. And click Sign Up. Now let's select the Tag Assistant tab and select the Click Event. On the Tags tab, we can see our newsletter button tag didn't fire. Let's select this. We can see two of our conditions matched, but Google Tag Manager wasn't able to see that the form was successfully submitted. This means we can't use the form validation option for our trigger, so our choice is to track the button even if someone hasn't successfully completed the form, or we need to use a different approach. Today we're going to use another approach to track people completing the form. Let's head back to the website, and let's right-click the thank you message, and select Inspect. We can see the thank you message is contained in a div with a class of form-submission-text. Let's copy this, and let's head back to Google Tag Manager. Now let's navigate to Triggers, and select the Email Sign-Up Form trigger. Let's click to edit the trigger, and let's change the trigger type to Element Visibility. Now let's choose CSS Selector as the selection method. And let's enter dot and paste the class we copied as the element selector. Now let's leave the defaults and adjust the conditions so we have one condition for page path, then equals, and then enter the page path for the form. This is /example/email-newsletter. Now let's save the trigger. And let's click Preview. Our website loads. And let's complete the form. We can now see the thank you message, so let's open the Tag Assistant tab. And we can see our tag is fired because the thank you message was visible. So this is a great technique to use if your forms aren't compatible with the form validation option available in Google Tag Manager. Now let's head back to Google Tag Manager. And let's remove the Click All Elements trigger. And now let's navigate to Variables, and let's click Configure for the built-in variables. Now let's disable all of the variables we don't need. So let's deselect Click Element, Click ID, and Click Target. We didn't use these, and we can always enable them again if we need them in the future. And we can also disable all of the form variables as we didn't use these either. Now we can close this. And we can click Submit to publish the changes to our live website. We name our version. And click Publish. We will now be tracking the banner button and when people successfully complete the form on our website. Finally, I want to briefly run through the events that Google Analytics can automatically collect using the enhanced measurement feature. Let's head to my blog to see a summary of these events. Scrolling down, I've listed all of the events that will automatically be collected by default. We can see there is the click event for outbound links, the file download event for clicks to download files, form start and submit events, and video events when people click to watch embedded YouTube videos on your website. So it's worth taking a moment to check if any events are being automatically collected into your reports. To learn more about these automatic events and the enhanced measurement feature, you can check out my dedicated tutorial. I'd love to know what custom clicks you're going to track into GA4. Let me know in the comments below. And if you haven't already, please take a moment to subscribe to my channel for all of my latest tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.